Do you remember how it all began? It just seemed like heaven, so I did it.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to welcome Teddy Riley to Georgia Piedmont's 2015 commencement ceremony as our commencement speaker. I know some of you remember Guy and Backstreet and Michael Jackson's Dangerous. This is the Ted Riley, who is right in the middle of all of that. Ted is a well-known, innovative musical artist credited with the formation of New Jack Swing music, a successful business person, and a clearly talented producer, musician, and entertainer. He has the impressive ability to relate to artistic geniuses such as Michael Jackson, Bobby Brown, and many, many others, but he's not lost the common touch, and that's why we invited him to be our commencement speaker. Teddy grew up, like me and many others, in public housing. He grew up in the St. Nicholas Housing Project in Central Harlem, and he uses considerable gifts to overcome challenging circumstances, as many of you have done today. He rose to be one of America's top music producers. He's extremely talented, but make no mistakes, he had to work hard and be disciplined to succeed. And all of us will have to work hard and be disciplined to continue to succeed as you worked hard and were disciplined to succeed to get your certificates, diplomas, or degrees today. And in succeeding, he's now able to give back to causes he believes in, such as feeding the homeless and then working with us in our music and television and film production programs at the college. Upon meeting him, I was struck by his commitment and desire to share his talents and insight with our students and other students, and especially those who come from similar backgrounds to his. At Georgia Piedmont, Teddy has been extremely supportive, as I mentioned already, of our television, film, and music production program. As we educate professionals, particularly minority professionals, who will be in a position to change the images of ourselves and our communities, this program that Teddy is affiliated with and supporting will have far-reaching impact. Ladies and gentlemen, the following video presentation highlights Teddy's long and outstanding music career. And after that, the next voice will be none other than that of Mr. Teddy Riley. Roll the video, please.
Teddy Riley, creator of New Jack Swing.
Shape the world of music as we know it. Let's take a tour on some of the many products Teddy Riley's responsible for.
It takes two to make a thing do right. It takes two to make it out of sight.
Remember this?
You are listening to the sounds of
check baby 1 2 3 4 check baby 1 2 3 check baby 1 2
everybody's talking all this stuff about me. Why don't they just let me live?
Tell me why.
I don't need permission, make my own decisions.
Hey!
That's my prerogative.
I'm
production skill sets, Teddy's career continued to flourish.
And I know love will be right here, be right here.
Drink, drop, reverse.
It's going down, fade to Black Street. The homies got at me, collab creations. Bump like agony, no doubt. I put it down, never slouch. As long as my credit can vouch, a dog couldn't catch me. Say tell me, sit. Still moving this flavor with the homies Black Street and Teddy, the original rough shakers.
By no means average. It's on when she's got to have it. Baby, you're a perfect 10. I wanna get in. Can I get down so I can? I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Bag it up.
I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
New Jack Swing never died. It went global.
Bring the boys out.
And combined with K-pop.
Girls, bring the boys out.
All the boys, all the boys.
What I heard. Better know how to rock in the stop.
Bring the boys out.
Hey, girl. 영원 같던 찰나
운명 같은 순간
나를 한순간 뚫고 가
너처럼
내 이름 불러주면 나에게로 다가와
몰라 순간처럼 낮춰 너를 마주하는 순간 Oh my 편하게 여기 앉아 이제 내 얘기를 들
나는 것들을 만나 그 안에 진짜를 봐봐
Call me baby, babe. Call me baby
너는 왜 지금 입을 막고 있네 흘러가는 소리도 따르기로 했네
Hey mama 식단 내가 아야야야야
Class of 2015 Teddy Riley has taken his skills around the world.
Good morning, everyone. How y'all doing? I want to say to everyone, it's an honor to be here, and I'm emotional right now because this is the best, you know, the biggest day of my life, just like you all. So I want to say to Georgia Piedmont Technical College, 2015 graduates, congratulations. This is your time. This day is all about you, and you deserve it. Everything that you put into it and the time that you put into it, this is the result. My name is Edward Theodore Riley II. My friends call me Teddy. It's the first time I ever gave many people my government name. But you could call me Teddy or TR. Some of my friends call me 1-2. And why they call me 1-2 is because everything I do is on the 1 or the 2. It's like... So, I want to go by... First of all, I want to thank my friend, who, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here today. And I want to thank him for the opportunity of just even being on this stage in front of the greatness in our next future. Greatness. You all will be going to that next level, just like I did, 20 years plus in the business. Dr. Jabari Samama, I don't know, I can't express, you know, how I'm feeling right now. I'm a little nervous, but I feel like I'm a great man and Superman up here because you put me in this position. So, and I'm really happy to be a part of the board of directors for developing new curriculums and things that will be happening at this incredible futuristic school. So, I want to take you all on a journey. I was born in Harlem, New York. In the projects, I was raised right around the corner from the Apollo Theater, which was my dream to be in that building. My school was right across the street from the Apollo. The backstage was the backyard of my school, Harry and Tubman, PS 154. So I didn't never play with the kids. I always went to the fence to see who was going to be backstage. And I seen people like James Brown, Marvin Gaye. And one day I got to go to the Apollo to see this film called Save the Children. And there was a film first, and then the actual screen rised up, and there was Marvin Gaye singing. And he was the soundtrack of the film. So he was singing in the film, and then after, he would perform. And that's how the Apollo was. We had a movie first, and then screen would go up, and there would be a performance. So I got to go to the Apollo one day. I was 5 years old, and I went with my babysitters to go see Gladys Knight and the Pips. And I was actually dancing, standing on a chair, dancing in my seat, doing the steps just like the Pips. And Gladys actually caught me. She caught me dancing to her music, and she picked me up on the stage, and she was singing Neither One of Us Wants to Be the First to Say Goodbye. And later on, I got to tell her, you picked me up on the stage when I was 5 years old, when I was working on the Winans, It's Time to Make That Change. She was there at my session. That tells you how God works. He's special. And that took me further into my career, becoming a multi-platinum, Grammy Award-winning producer, singer. And I don't want anybody to get it twisted. I actually started singing. Aaron Hall taught me how to sing and taught me what I needed to do to make it on the stage, because my manager was like, you gotta be visually seen to actually get people to know who you are as a producer. So I went out there, and as you can see in the video, I'm singing songs like this, Fantasy and No Diggity. And my mom said to me, you can do this. So I said to myself, I could do this. Just like you all saying to yourself, no one made you go to this school. No one made you go back to school to get your degree. You did it yourself. You pushed yourself. So with all that being said, I didn't have my father in my life to push me. I had older cousins that would teach me how to be tough, but they never pushed me to do this music. What pushed me to do what I did, and that made me who I am today, was God. Now, at one time, I did backslide, and I went and hang out with the friends in the streets, and I did the street thing, until my mom said, you're not gonna make it there. You better go do that music, and you better get back in school. And that's what I did. I work with the best. such as Michael Jackson, and discovered artist producers such as Pharrell Williams. And I've toured the world. That's a good accomplishment. But being on this stage today, like I said, is one of my biggest accomplishments, is to be in front of you, and I am honored. But there's one key point missing. So I am just like everyone in this room. I wake up in the morning and I thank my Lord Savior Jesus Christ. I brush my teeth or I will have funky breath. And the one thing I do so that it disciplines me is I make my bed every day. Yes. Why? Because you gotta do something every day that'll discipline you so that when you go out there, you know, you're gonna get your hands dirty, you're gonna get your feet wet. Basically, I face a lot of decisions and meet a lot of challenges on a daily, just like you. I want to actually share with you all some tools that made me who I am today, and I'm sure you all can relate to this. I'm a hard worker. I'm a competing hard worker. Even if I'm not competing with anyone, I'm competing with myself. And when I say to myself, I'm gonna grind harder than you. I'm gonna be in a studio for 48 hours, no sleep. Sometimes I eat, sometimes I don't think about eating because I'm striving to be the best. I learned from people like Michael Jackson, settle for nothing less than great. I'm a relationship builder because there's no I in we. I've never been solo, which is why you never see me do a solo album. I like team, just like my team here. Being in the business 20 years, it's a long time, but that comes with being humble. My mom taught me how to be humble. She said, that is gonna take you a long way. 20 years plus, I'm still here and I'm in front of you. I'm a risk taker as well. If you don't take the risk, you'll never find out what it is going to be. So some risks you take, they're not successful, but you learn. As long as you're learning from that risk, you're learning and you're growing. I believe in faith. I moved in Atlanta by faith, from Virginia to Atlanta, and I stayed in a hotel for 11 weeks with my children, assistants, security. That was a lot of money. But I said, this is the place I'm supposed to be. And look at me now. I'm still here. I'm a big time dreamer. My dreams have brought me where I'm at today, because when I had my dreams, I put them in the universe. And me having those dreams, those are the things that I wanted to actually take my life to, and I put it out in the universe, and I kept saying, I want to be a star. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. And everything that I said, you all got it from my spirit. And you all made me who I am today. So, dreaming is a great thing. The other thing I want to say to you is, it's good to be between. Being between is the great part of what you're doing, what you have done, the 2 years or 3 years you've been here. Because if you were at the beginning, you'd be starting over. If you're at the end, you're gonna have to start over. So being in between is the fun part. Right now we're having a bittersweet because you're going to be leaving your friends. You're going to be leaving the professors, the president. So I like this. I'm in between my next mission. I got the chance to, unlike you, I didn't go to college, but I went to the University of MJJ, Michael Joe Jackson. That was a hard university to go to because, you know, it's a state of shock and it's a nervousness. You had to, all of that stuff had to come down once the professor make you comfortable. So Michael Jackson, the professor, kind of made me comfortable after a little while of working with him. Because it was hard to tell Michael, you're singing off, you're off key. You would be nervous too, because you would wonder what he's going to say. What are you talking about, man? So I had to get used to him, and he had to learn me as a person, as a producer. So working with him, I was trying to get to the music part, and he was like, no, like all professors, no, you gotta have the tools, you gotta have your books, you gotta have all the proper things before we go and start doing music and getting to work. So it took about 4 days, 5 days, which was, you know, it got a little, I was tired, I wanted to do music. So finally, when we got to the studio, everything he learned about me was in the studio. We had game room. I told him I like to stay by my music. He had a bedroom there for me. He had everything, home-cooked meals. Well, finally, it was that time for my first exam. Listen to my demos. And we listened to 5 songs. First song was this song. And Michael, as a professor, he's like, next song. Still didn't get no reaction. Professor is not impressed. He's not impressed with what I was playing. So I said, next song. Now I'm starting to get I was like, all right. Next song. I know you're wondering why I'm playing a Blackstreet song, and that song is called Joy. I did that song for Michael Jackson first, and we wind up writing it for Blackstreet. And then I got this from him. He loved the song so much. But when we did this song, so he said, stop. He looked at me and said, can I see you in my office? So I went with him to the office. I thought I was in trouble. I thought I was going to be expelled. Thought I was going to get detention. Or, you know, have to stay after school and do some more music, go back to the drawing board. Well, what Michael wanted to know was, what was that chord that was played, the first chord of Remember the Time? And I told him, I looked at him with confidence and I said, I don't know that chord. He said, I said, let me explain. I don't know that chord because I don't read music. Everything comes from my fingers and my ears. I play what I hear and it comes from here. And he felt that. But he said to me, that chord was never played in any of my music. Of all the things and all of the songs that I've written and sang, I've never heard that chord before. That is very brilliant. And all the nervousness went down. My nerves was just, I was like, yeah. Yeah, I did it. I was like, my mom, everybody was like, I did it. My friends, I called my little brother from Rex and Effect, Markel, and I said, yo, man, he liked one of my songs. And you know, I just want to say, lastly, I want to share the importance of time with you. That word time is very important and will be, it is important to you because you put in the time to be here and look at your victory. It's your time. And this world is yours. When you leave here, I hope that what I've done in my speech can take you to that level of never settling for nothing and never settling for no.
Remember the time.
At least settle for, let me get back to you. But don't settle for no. Keep knocking on them walls, because you did it at Georgia Piedmont Technical College.
Remember the time.
And I again want to thank you for giving me this opportunity. And I want to say congratulations. The world is yours. Georgia Piedmont Technical College graduates, congratulations. I am Teddy Riley. Thank you. Peace and love.
Remember the time.